Namaskar to all. Today we are discussing about Gheran Samhita. Gheran Samhita is a dialogue between Rishi Gheran and King Chandkapali. Gheran Rishi have explained various Hatha yogic practices in the term of Ghat Yoga. He have not used a term Hatha Yoga, but he is using the term Ghat Yoga, that is a yoga which is based on the approach through the body. Ghat is a technical term used for human body, not only physical one, but the psychophysical unit that is responsible for another birth. The sequence of this birth and death chain can be broken by the practice of yoga. Ghat Shuddhi is a concept given by Maharishi Gheran, which is not used for purification, but for the liberation process also. He have explained this topic in seven steps or seven limbs, that is also known as Sapta Sadhana or Saptang Yoga. These seven steps are Shatkarm, Asan, Mudra, Pratyahar, Pranayam, Dhyan and Samadhi, which gives us purification, strength, stability, dhita, lightness, pratyaksh and nirlipta bhav. Shatkarm are cleansing process which is kept at the first place as first limb, and which is used to balance between tridosha, between the prana flow in ira and pingala, and cleans our body from inside and keep us healthy. Gheran Rishi have explained deeply or very nicely Shat Kriya, and that is why 21 types of Shuddhi Kriyas have been explained in this topic, as 13 types of dhoti, 2 types of vasti, 1 neti, 1 tratak, 1 noli and 3 types of kapalbhati have been given in Ghat Yoga or Gheran Samhita. Second step after Shat Karma is known as Asan, and Asan, just 32 asanas have been mentioned out of 84 asana. Siddhasana is the first one which opens the door of realization as per Gheran Samhita. Hatha Yoga Pradipika have explained 15 asanas, and along with these 15 asanas, Gheran Rishi have been explained some other asanas which can be seen on the presentation. Now comes to the mudra topic, which is the next one, and means seal and closure in Sanskrit, and Nabo Mudra, Ma Mudra, Udyan, Jalandhar, Moolband, Mahaband, Mahaved, Khechari, Vipreet Karni, Yoni, Vajroli, Shakti, Chalini, Taragi, Mandavi, Shambhavi, Bhujangini, Matangi, Kaki, Pashini, Ashwani, along with Panchadharna. Pratyaha means Pratyi plus Ahar, means the opposite Ahar of the Indriyas, and five types of senses should be controlled with the help of mind. This is the concept of Pratyahara. Pratyahara concept have been explained before Pranayama concept, and the Pranayama concept have been explained in chapter number 5 or the 5th limb. Pranayama are the 8 types of Pranayama have been explained in this book, and we have separately given the video for the Pranayama topic. But in 5th chapter, along with Pranayama, place of practice, concept of Matha, season to start practice, Patya Patya and Mitahar concept, and importance of purification of the nadis have been given in this chapter or in this step. So, what is about concept of Matha? Sudheshe, Dharmik Rajye, Subhikshe Nirupadarve, Kritva Tatrekam Kutiram, Prachire Parveshtitam, means there should be boundary, there should have some boundary. Vapi Kup Taragam Cha Prachir Madhyavarti, Nati Usham, Nati Nimnam Cha Kutiram Kit Vajitam, means it should be safe, it should be boundaried, or everything could be easily available. So, season, one should not start here with practice in the season of Hemant, Shishir, Grishm and Varsha. It can cause sickness. So when we start in Vasant and Sharad Ritu, we should start our practice. It will attain a success and becomes disease free. This is the good time to start. Then the Patya Patya and Mitaha means food which is pure, sweet, lubricated and fills only half the stomach, which is digestible. This type of food should be taken after offering to the god. One should fill half of the stomach with food, one quarter with water, and fourth quarter should be leave empty for the air, and this is the concept of mitaha. Purification of nadis can be done with the samanu and nimanu method. Samanu method is can be completed with the help of beech mantra, while nimanu method can be done or completed dhoti karma. Dhoti karma have been explained in Shatkam topic previously, and in 5th chapter, Samanu with Vrij Mantra have been explained very nicely. Next was Dhyana. Dhyana have been explained, Sthul, Jyoti and Shukshma Dhyan. There are three types of Dhyan that can be done with the image, with the light and with Brahma as Bindu. Teju Dhyan is the 100 times superior to Sthul Dhyan. Shukshma Dhyan is greatest of all and 100,000 times superior to Teju Dhyan. Explained by Ghiren Rishi. Sthul Dhyan means by meditation on image. Jyoti means light and Bindu. Like Samadhi. Samadhi means Shambhavi, Bhramri, Khechri, Yoni Mudra. And the fifth one is Bhakti and the sixth one is Manomorcha. These are the six steps or sixfold Samadhi. With the help of these, we can go towards the Samadhi side. Through Bhakti leads to Ashva, Sattvic Bhav, and through Manomurcha we will get calmness of mind, and it leads to Samadhi again. Tat Yoga explained that body is purified and freed from disease through Shatkarma, and then other poses help the body to accept higher energy or attainment of Mukti. That is why Ghiren Sahita is not the Hatha Yogic practice. It is not the topic which help us in purification of body only. It also help us into the going towards the liberation. So I really wish that you like this video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe the channel. And for pranayama topic and other various topics which is explained in other videos, so please try to see that topic.